So we sometimes have to talk about sort of an unsavory topic, and we don't like to, but the best way to do it is to do it head on, take it straight on. And tonight's show is going to be about toenail fungus. It kind of reminds me of a 70s commercial where they take your mother-in-law aside and said, we have something to talk to you about. It's your toenail fungus. But it is a very common problem, and it's virtually untreatable, it seems to be, at least not quickly, not easily, and not very cheaply. So we're going to talk about a little bit of background about the disorder. A lot of you out there probably had it. We're going to talk about ways to prevent it, perhaps, ways to recognize it, and then some new exciting ways that really show some promise about moving the needle in terms of treatment. So with us first is podiatrist Larry Kosova, who is a podiatrist from Naperville, and also a resident of Chicago. And first of all, tell us a little bit of background about the disorder. How common is it? And where are some of the origins from it?
Okay, well, the term toenail fungus is a medical term, and it's kind of a fancy term. We call it onychomycosis.
What?
So even just the term sounds bad.
Yeah.
And it's caused by, it's basically a fungal infection that attacks the nail and the nail plate. So if you just take your finger, this is the nail plate, and I always tell people that the nail plate lies on the nail bed. And the infection actually will start in the nail plate,
Put this over.
There you go.
Talk about
and the ones to the left are the ones that are really bad, and the
right
ones
here?
Right, and the ones that are right are after treated of
right.
The treatment that we'll discuss in a little bit.
Okay.
So you can see pitting, you can see yellowness, you can see thickening. A lot of times there'll be pain associated with it. People will get it from, it could be hereditary or walking around going to a gym or going to a pool, and then you're walking around in bare feet and your feet are basically hitting the carpet. Somebody else has fungus, on their skin. We call that athlete's foot or tinea pedis, and that can actually migrate up to the nails. So that's some ways that you could get it. It's really more prevalent really in people from their 20s to 40s, but you could see it in very old and in very young, but in our clientele, that's what we tend to see it in. I think the number that I last saw was like 45 million people are infected with toenail fungus. So even though we sort of joke about it and it's a little bit unsightly, mm-hmm. in the clientele that we have, it becomes more of a bigger issue. It is a true infection of the nail plate.
Yes.
And it's something that really needs to find a cure. And the treatments out there, I've been practicing for 22 years, and the treatments out there right now just haven't been really good to get rid of it. We have things and ways to control the nail fungus, but nothing to really resort in trying to get the nail back to a normal-looking nail.
By the way, we are happy to take your calls about this topic or any foot-related topic that you want to address. We'll have a couple of podiatrists on for the show. Why has the treatment been so elusive on this disorder? It seems so straightforward and simple and so common. One would think that with all the medical science and technology behind it, that a cure would be more forthcoming.
It's funny because a lot of patients will have what we call the wise tail type of treatments. It'll be anything from soaking in vinegar or soaking in different oils that their grandmothers told them, and they swear that has gotten basically rid of the toenail fungus, to anything to the latest medications that we have now. People might hear of oral medications, or their doctors might be prescribing something like Lamisil or Sporinox, which are oral medications that you could take from anywhere between 3 and 9 months. And then the theory is that it attacks the systemic part of the fungus and it starts reversing that cycle. And we have actually seen some good results with that. The problem with those oral medications, and the main problem, is really liver toxicity. So it raises your liver enzymes, and you're doing blood tests every month to monitor it. It actually becomes very expensive. It's not a cheap drug. Then you're getting the lab tests monthly to monitor it. And the worst problem is, Chris, is that the recurrence rate of the fungus afterwards is anywhere between 20% and 40%. And the success rate of the orals is really about 34% to 50% of the patients that are actually taking them are actually seeing some sort of, backtracking of the fungus.
And the liver toxicity issue is even prevalent in people that don't have liver problems, have virtually healthy
livers? Yeah, that was actually one of the problems why we stopped using it about 12 years ago. We used it for a couple of years. Things started looking pretty good. And then in their research, there was actually incidences of males in their 50s, and I'm sure females too, that actually got liver toxicity and died. So I joke around with my patients. I said, you know, I don't like using those medications. I'm just here to treat you. I'm just a foot and ankle doc. I'm not trying to kill you. So, the sales pitch. The sales pitch, right. You know, so the problem is that we're dealing with different types of infections. One is called T. rubrum. The other ones could be candidus. I mean, there's different types of fungal infections out there, and there's just not great medications to actually treat them. Even in the lab, they're hard to treat. Mm-hmm. And there's really, you know, you could debride the nails, you could reduce them down and try to clean up the area. There's some topicals that you could buy over the counter at most of the pharmacies that are out there. But nothing has really proven well to treat and keep the problem away. Reoccurrence is really a big issue.
Now, let's transition to the reason we're here tonight, and that's to talk about a relatively exciting technology. As you know, on the show, we don't really talk about a lot of interesting cutting-edge technology in this show, because there really isn't that many things, there aren't that many things that occur that are so exciting, but you and our next guest, Dr. Pandit, are going to be talking about a laser treatment. And so let me turn it over to you, and we'll put this overhead up so the viewers can see kind of what this device looks like. And why don't you tell us a little bit about how this was developed, what it is, and how it treats the problem I'll try and kind of
there's different type of lasers on the market. There's uniwave lasers and dual wave lasers. Every company has their own advantages and disadvantages. This is the Noveon laser. It's the only dual wave laser in the market. In our practice now, we have the only Noveon in the state of Illinois. So this is brand new. We've had it for about 2 weeks. We're actually treating our second dose of patients. Mm-hmm. A lot of the uniwave lasers are working on a smaller spectrum of wavelength. So when they're going after and trying to eradicate the nail fungus, which is really a multiple type of organism, it's not one organism versus the other, mm-hmm. It only works on certain types of organisms. So you might see some retrieval and some of the nail fungus actually reducing, mm-hmm. but the question is how much is that going to come back after a year, and how much good are we really doing for the patient? So mm-hmm. you might see in the nail plate some of the clearing. If you want to show the picture of the nails, that will just make a little bit more sense to the people watching. So you have over to the left on the top, which is a moderate or mild type of infection, and mm-hmm. then below you have a more severe infection of the nail plate. The whole idea is that we want to get clearing and we want to go back to a normal right nail here, which is all the way to the right. A lot of the uniwave lasers that are on the market mm-hmm. will get clearing of the nail plate, but not going completely back to a clear nail. With the Noveon, we're using two different wavelengths. It's an 870 and a 930 wavelengths to basically kill the different types of organisms in the nail plate itself, what's causing the infections. Mm-hmm. The other interesting thing, too, it's also antibacterial, what we call bactericidal. Mm-hmm. So it actually works on MRSA, and it's the only laser on the market that has 100% cidal rate or kill rate of MRSA infections.
And how is the laser administered? We'll pull this device up again.
This is a little bit different than most lasers on the market. In fact, this is different than every laser on the market for this problem. Where you're pointing to now is something that we call topod. We actually put on a plastic cap on each of the nails. That is, you know, one is a large one is a small one for the big toe, and the mm-hmm. other toe is on the market.
Right.
And then we take off one of those pods that you're pointing to, and we actually attach it to the toe.
Right.
And we push a button, and it's a 16-minute administered pulse of laser.
Mm-hmm. And the patient doesn't feel it much at all, really.
There's a little bit of warmth. If you see that, there's a little bit of button there. There's a wire that goes to a button.
Yeah, this one right
if
here.
The patient does feel any warmth that's uncomfortable, they could push the button, which stops the machine, mm-hmm. and then an operator has to come into the room and basically restart it. Mm-hmm. We've had one patient that pushed it. It was a male, and we were finding that the guys tend to feel the warmth a little bit more than the females. I don't know why that is.
Because guys don't can't tolerate pain as much as women. Everyone knows that.
But
right?
It really wasn't painful. He was actually just a little bit unaware, even mm-hmm. though we explained him what was going on. Then once we restarted the machine, he was like, oh, that's fine. That's good. Most of our patients are reading a magazine during the 16 mm-hmm. minutes. We'll give them some water, having them relax. They can play music if they choose to. But other than that, it's actually a pretty mm-hmm. relaxing experience.
Oh, we got our first call. The caller didn't want to be on the air, but we'll have you answer this call, and then we'll shift to Dr. Panett here. Referring to the laser treatment, does this work for advanced toenail fungus?
If you want to go back to the picture, I could show you. Yes, I mean...
this one or this one?
That one right there. The advanced stage would be the one on the bottom.
Down here, right.
It's actually worse looking than that. This was actually after a nail was actually debrided down, actually uh-huh. taking off some of the top coat.
Yeah.
So, yes, I mean, it will work for both mild stages and advanced stages of onychomycosis or fungus of the nails.
Okay, great. Well, we're going to shift to Dr. Panett. Thanks for your time.
Always.
Appreciate
Chris.
It.